Open up ye ancient doors, let the King of glory come in. We speak to our hearts, lift up your head, O ye gates. Open up ye ancient doors, let the King of glory come in. Let the King of glory come in. Desires to fill the room, fill the room, fill the room, fill the room,
fill the room, fill the room,
yeah, 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 fill the room, fill the room of our hearts, of our minds, of our spirit. Fire souls, fill every room, Jesus. Fill every room, Jesus.
Glory, glory, glory. Well, praise the Lord, somebody. 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 Hallelujah. Come on, clap those hands and bless the Lord for his goodness. Amen. Listen, this has been a tremendous weekend at a very beautiful resort. The Lord has met us and we've enjoyed the Lord. His goodness, amen. Look at your neighbor and ask him a question. Have you got one more? And you got one more? We need you to give us one more, just one more. One more push, one more praise, one more prayer, one more shout, amen. One more worship, amen. And we'll be across the finish line. But we're so grateful, amen, to the floors, Pastor Candy and Pastor Steve for this great, great weekend in Jesus' name. Now listen. I have been one of us in February. I'll be 60 years old. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I thank the Lord for that. I look pretty good for 60, I think. Bless the Lord. Amen. So, but I have been one of us for almost 60 years. What do I mean by that? After we eat, we know how we get. So it's my assignment to wake you up and stir you up and get you ready for this word that's going to come forth. The Bible says we'll hear, this is preachers right here know this. Ecclesiastes said, let us hear the conclusion of the matter. Let us hear the conclusion of the matter. So do me a favor. I know you just sat down, but let me do you like the Catholic Church. If you've ever been to Catholic Church, they tell you, stand up, sit down. Stand up, sit down. Stand up, sit down. Get up on your feet right now and go and greet your sister right now. Go and greet somebody and tell them, God has blessed me this weekend. Come on, tell somebody, God has blessed me. God has blessed me in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Come on, greet your neighbor. Hug somebody real quick. In Jesus' name. We got our tracks ready. Our track's good to go. Bless the Lord. Amen. Pastor Steve, this is old school in here. Bless the Lord. Amen. We're going to jump in. Amen. Come on. The Bible says, clap your hands, all you people. Shout to God with a voice of triumph. So we give him praise and glory. Let's go in. Let's go in with this one. Yeah. Hallelujah. While you're greeting your sister, come back to see. Put your hand together. Let's go. Clap them. Let's go. Clap, clap, clap. Get up on your feet. Yeah. Psalm 47 verse 1 says, clap your hands, O you people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. It says this. Hey. Lord, most high is mighty. Great in power, Paul is he. He shall subdue the heathens and place nations under our feet. Hey. He shall subdue them, the sound of the trumpet and the shout of victory. Come on, people, put your hands together. Praise our God and King. Yeah. Lord, most high is mighty. Great in power, full is he. Shall subdue the heathens and place nation under our feet. This is what he does. He shall subdue them, the sound of the trumpet and the shout of victory. Come on, people, put your hands together. Praise our God and King. I'll praise destroy the enemy. With continual praise, demons have to flee. Clap your hands. Put them together. Let's go. Shout it to God. Clap your hands. Yeah. Shout unto God. Well, God most high and mighty, great in power, Paul is he. He shall subdue the heathens and place nations under. This is what's happening in Israel right now. I don't know if y'all notice what's happening right now. He shall subdue them, the sound of the trumpet and the shout of victory. Come on, put your hands together. Praise our God and King. I pray, destroy the enemy. But continue our praise. Give it time to flee. Clap your hands. Yeah. Hey. Shout out to God. Clap your hands. Yeah. Shout out to God. Everybody clap your hands. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout out to God. Hey. Clap your hands. Yeah. That's a good one. Shout out to God. Come on, clap your hands. Hey. Shout out to God. Put them together and clap your hands. Come on, move that lunch around a little bit. Move it around. Shout out to God. Say it again. Just clap your hands. Put a smile on your face and give him praise. Shout out to God. Say it again. Clap your hands. Yeah, shout out to God. Now clap and shout. Come on. Because he's given us victory. That's why we clap him with our hands. Worship with our hands. Praise him with our hands. Come on, give God praise. Yeah. All of your days. Put them together. Let's go. Give God praise. Hey. All of your days. Clap your hands. Hey. Say, shout out to God. Come on, say, clap your hands. You got it, you got it. Say, shout out to God. One word, shout, clap. Clap. Put them together, let's go. Come on, say, shout. Yeah. One word, say it, clap. There it is. Yeah, yeah, shout unto God. Say it again, clap, say it, clap. Yeah. Come on, say shout. There it is. One more time, clap your One word, say shout. Now do me a favor, press in. Let me see you clap your hands. Let's go, come on. Act like the enemy's beginning to between your hands right now. While you're clapping, you're warring. While you're clapping, you're fighting. While you're clapping, you're warring. While you're clapping, you're fighting. While you clap your hands, come on, hey. This is the sound of a war. We war like never before. Yeah. Cut. Happy. Then you won't pray. Demons have to flee. One more time. Cut your hand. Come on, put your hand together. Give him praise because he's worthy. The glory and the honor belong to him. Nobody like him. Come on, clap your hands and worship. Need no music. Clap. 2, 3, 4. Clap. 2, 3, 4. Put them together. Stay right there. Stay right there. Clap those hands and bless the Lord. Come on. Clap those hands and bless the Lord. Come on. Clap those hands and bless the Lord. Come on. We say clap your hands. Say clap. With the voice of triumph, say it again. Say, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice. One more time, say it. Clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of one more time. Say, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God. One more time, say, clap your hands. Everybody say, clap your hands. Now go ahead and do it. You just sung about it. Do it. Lift him up in the room one more time. We said it last night, but say it one more time. Tell somebody God's a mighty God. Let's go. Let's go. Put them together. Come on. Get your hands together like delight. Get your hands together like delight. Come. Come on. Move them nachos around. Move that lunch around. We give him praise. It says you are God. Yes. And you mean the world to me. You're number one God, yes, cause there's no one beside me, yes. You are he who, hey, rules and reigns over everything. You are he who, hey God, when dominion of authority. You are a mighty God. Have I got a witness in the room? Is he mighty? I can't hear you. Is he mighty? Yes, he is. Yes, he is. You are a mighty God. Hey. That's why we give you praises. We exalt you, King. Somebody say, you are a mighty God. Yeah. Because you're ruling and reigning over everything. You are a mighty God. Hey. That's why we give you praise one more time. Come help me say it. You are. Come on, push through. And you mean
the world.
Hey,
to me.
Yeah, you're number one, God. Yeah. No one beside thee.
No beside.
He's worthy, y'all.
You are he who.
Got your rule, your reign.
Rules and reigns over everything.
You are he who. Yeah, let's say it one more time, y'all. Quench dominion and authority.
You are
a mighty God. Yes, we worship and praise your name because
you are
a mighty God. Yes, you always stay the same because
He's
a mighty God. Yes, we'll ever bless and praise your holy name. Say,
you are a mighty God.
Come on, one more time, and they'll come late. Come on and give his name the praise because you are holy. Yes, he is. Somebody shout about it. Somebody shout it.
Holy.
Yes, he is. Somebody say it.
Holy.
Can you help us say? Come on, help us say it.
Holy.
Say, oh.
Holy.
Yes, he is.
Holy.
He's wonderful. He's counselor. He's mighty God.
Holy.
Prince of peace, everlasting Father.
Holy.
Mighty one, sovereign one, holy one. on, phenomenal women. God is all that. Hey, hey, can you help us say it?
All that.
Hey, hey, can you help us say it?
All that. We won't stop praising your name because you say, oh, yes, you are. Unchanging, unchanging God. Unfailing, unfailing God. Unstoppable, all powerful God. Just one more time, can you help me say? Shout about it if you know he's all that. Do me a favor, act like you in church. Put your hand on four or five people and say, all that, all that. Come on, tell somebody, all that. He's been all that this weekend. Come on, tell somebody, he's been all that. He's been all that, he's been all that. Pastor Steve, Pastor Candy was in our church, one worship service on a particular day, and my pastor was having remarks. He's talking about Valley Kingdom, H. Daniel Wilson. He's just saying, he said, our church, the Lord has blessed, the Lord has prospered the valley. The Lord has kept us. He's made us a prosperous church in him. And as he began to speak, the Lord began to speak to my spirit and say, you know, when people say I'm good, I'm really better than that. I say, huh? And that's when I discovered the time that you don't leave the sanctuary is after you finish singing and go take a break while the preacher's going forth. Now, the worshipers, how many of you know the worshipers need to stay up under the word too? Praise the Lord. He said to me, he said, people say I'm great. I'm really greater than that. Why is that? There really are no human words to properly and adequately describe how good and how great I am. So if I say he's rich, what is he? If I say he's strong, what is he? If I say he's great, what is he? Tell somebody he's been more and more. Tell somebody on the other side he's been more. This is for Pastor Candy. I need you to come out of them seats right now. Come out of them seats. Let's go. Put your hand together. Let's go. Come on. Yeah. Pastor Steve, this that DC go-go beat. They don't know nothing about that in Chicago. And listen, my mother was from the greater West Side. West Side Chicago in the room. I see you in the back. What's up? Round about time they heard music like this, sis. My mama and them would be doing it. Oh, I'm sorry. We in church. Y'all forgive me. I'm sorry. But we're celebrating the goodness of the Lord. Tell somebody he's better. Tell somebody he's better. Yes, he is. We give him praise. Pastor, the Lord gave me a song. He said, what can I say, yes, about your mercy? What can I say, yeah, about your grace? All that I know, yeah, is that you've been faithful, huh, that I know, as I love to call his name. I say again, what can I say, yes, about his mercy? What can I say about his grace? All that I know, God's phenomenal woman, 2023. The Lord's been faithful one day for sure, as I love to call his name. Now, if I say he's good, he's been better than that.
You got it. Now, if I say he's great, he's been
greater than that.
Sit, you got it. Now, if I say he's sweet, he's been
sweeter than that.
He's been
more in my life.
Come on, let's worship the Lord. Come on. Now, if I say he's rich, he's been
richer than that.
You got it. I say he's strong, even
stronger than that.
Well, now I say he's holy, he's more. Well, you've been more. That's how we used to do it. Shoot, do, 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 shoot, do, do. Shoot, do, do, do. I see you, sis. She want to break out electric slide so bad. Shoot, do, 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 do. Yeah, he'll make you want the same. Listen, this is the close of the conference. You want to come out in the aisle and have some fun? Come on. Say, song says this. Say, what can I say now about your mercy? What can I say about your grace? All that I know, yes, God, is that the Lord's been faithful. One thing for sure is I love to call his name. Now if I say he's good, he's been
better than that.
You got it, you got it. Now if I say he's great, he's been
greater than that.
Well, now if I say he's sweet, he's been
sweeter than that.
He's been more
and more in my life.
Come on, help me say, help me say, help me say. Now if I say he's rich, he's been
richer than that.
Sing it now. Now if I say he's strong, he's been
stronger than that.
Well, now if I say he's holy, he's
more than that.
God, you've been more.
More, and more in my life.
Can you wave your hands in the air and say he's more?
More, and more in my life.
Lift your hand in the air and say he's more.
More, and more.
Wave your hands in the air and say more. Come on, help me move. Shake, shoot, do, 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 shoot, do, 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 shoot, do, 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 do. Yeah, we're getting out of the way, y'all. Shoot, do, 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 do. Well, well, he'll make you want the same. Come on, one last push, one more last push. Help me say it one more time. Help me say it, y'all. Now, if I say he's good, he's been
better than that.
Yeah, now if I say he's great, he's been
greater than that.
That's it, you got it. Now if I say he's sweet, he's been
sweeter than
well,
that.
He's been more.
More, and more.
I see you, Minister Angela Singh says, come on, help me say. If I say he's rich, what's it been, y'all? Rich. Yeah, now if I say he's strong, he's been
stronger than that.
Yeah, now I'm saying, holy Jesus,
more, more.
God, you've been more.
More, and more in my life.
Help me say, you've been so good, you're more and more.
More in my life.
Help me say it one more time, you've been more.
More, and more in my life.
Now come on, this is the last push, this is the last push. Now if God's been good to you, and you know that he's brought you through, now anybody who's a somebody and everybody just scream. Come on, let me see you move a little bit. Let me see you move. Come on, let me know you're awake. Let me know you're awake. Yeah. Come on, move in the house. Come on, let your spirit move. Go ahead, mother. Let your spirit. Look at mother over here getting in. Come on, let your spirit move. Somebody say glory. Glory. Shout glory. Come on, one more time, one more time. Somebody scream. Hey. God, we celebrate your goodness. Come on, one more push, I'm getting out of the way. God, you're worthy of the praise, the glory, and the honor. Because it's all about you, and it's not about us. You've been better than that. You've been good. You've been good. You've been better than that. You've been good. You've been good. You've been better than that. You've been good. You've been good. You've been better than. Come on, help me say this. Come on, say this. I know you've been good, but you've been
better than that.
Yes, you have. I know you've been good, but you've been
better than that.
Yes, you have. I know he's been good, but it's been
better than that.
Yes, he has. I know you've been good, but you've been
better.
Put your hand on somebody and say, he's better, he's better, he's better. And we speak and prophesy better healing, better grace, better anointing, better favor, better power, open doors, prosperity, increase, healing, deliverance.
the anointing, the spirit. Better, 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 better. Come on, better, better. Say, I know you've been good, but you've been better. Yes, you have. I know it's been good, but it's been better. Yes, you have. I know you've been good, but you've been, help me say, say better than that. Better than that. Sis, get ready. I'm getting out of here. Come on, say it. I know you've been great, but you've been. Yes, you have. I know you've been great, but you've been. Yes, she has. I know he's been great, but he's been greater. Greater than that. Greater than that. Come on, this is the last push. Last push. Come on, come on. I know you've been strong, but you've been stronger. Get your fist in the air, say it. I know you've been strong, but you've been stronger. Yes, sir, but oh my God. I know you've been strong, but you've been strong. Stronger than that. Stronger than that. One more time, somebody holla hallelujah, give him glory. Holla hallelujah, give him praise. There's nobody like him. He's worthy of the glory and the honor. Well, 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 you've been good. You've been good. You've been better than that. You've been good. You've been good. You've been better. Help me say, you've been good. Yeah, you've been good. Yeah, you've been better. Say it again. You've been good. You've been good. You've been bad. Say it one more time. You've been good. Yeah, you've been good. He's been better than that. Yes, he has. You've been good. You've been good. You've been better than that. One more time. Scream of praise in the room. Put your hand on somebody. Holler, better, 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 better. Come on, take 10 seconds. Prophesy of your neighbor. Better right now. Better in your family. Prophesy of your neighbor. Better in your home. Come on, better in your business. Come on, better in your family. Better, 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 better. Come on, better in your church. Come on, better, 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 better. Better in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come on, scream of praise.
Well, praise the Lord. We feel better. Amen. We feel better. Well, this is the last session. This is the last session, but we want to thank you all for being here the days and the nights. We really, really appreciate you, and we pray that everything that you came looking for, that you came expecting, that it will come to pass, hopefully and prayerfully, maybe before we get back home. Amen. We know that God is able to do that. Amen. So what we're going to do, I'm not going to welcome you again, but I just want to praise, thank God for you being here and coming back after having a little short break from lunch. Amen. It's a push for some of us. But what I want to do right now is I want everybody to stand to their feet and point toward Candy. Actually, stand to your feet and give Candy and Pastor Steve a great, great round of applause, as loud as you can make it. Come on, give it to them. Hallelujah. Come on. Don't get tired. Give it to them. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank you. Thank you all so very much. We thank you, Pastor Candy, Pastor Steve, for you all can be seated for this wonderful, wonderful conference. And I know that if you came expecting something, if you came looking for something, that you got just what you were looking for. Amen. I mean, you got just what you, you know, if you were coming to just be a spectator, you got that. But if you came looking for something, I'm going to get something out of this conference. I'm going to be more stronger. I'm going to be more powerful. I'm going to be everything that God wants me to be moving forward. My faith has gone from here to here. Amen. And you looking for that? You got it. Amen. So right now, I want to thank God for our virtual audiences that were tuning in all three times of the sessions. We thank God for you. You all can give them a hand as they listen to your applause. Amen. I forgot to mention while y'all were standing, you don't have to stand again, but look at your neighbor and say, you are phenomenal. Come on, say it loud. You are phenomenal. Sometimes we have to let each other know that you're phenomenal. You are phenomenal. You know, it doesn't matter what we look like now. God said that we're phenomenal. God said that we are this, so that's what we're going to be. That's what we're going to call ourselves, phenomenal. You're phenomenal. Pastor Candy, you are phenomenal. She said, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So if you all want to partner with Candy, Pastor Candy, and Pastor Steve's ministry, you have an opportunity to do that during the conference. And during the conference, you only got a little bit of time left, so y'all stop thinking about it. Just go ahead and do it. And be your a monthly partner with the ministry. And you will not regret it. You will not regret it. Their ministry is very anointed and very extremely blessed. So, and during this conference, if you become a partner with the with them, you will get a CD. Give Thanks CD. Or, emphasis on, or, Pastor Steve's Sounds of Healing Ministry. This is an acoustic piano, just to let you know. There's no singing on there. So it's just Pastor Steve playing the piano. It's really good. And I encourage you, if you're not sitting in here, if you are not a partner and you won't have to drive home, this is going to get you there. Really good. Candy CD as well. Gonna get you there, and I'm singing back up on one of those. Amen. So, and also, when you partner with us today and get one of those CDs, you will also get a Pray This Every Day little encouragement that you can put on whatever you want to put it on. You can take it with you, put it in your bag, put it in your briefcase, put it in your books, put it in your Bible. And it's Colossians chapter 1. Verses 9 through 14, and in the King James Version, and on the other side, it's the same book, Colossians chapter 1, verses 9 through 14 in the AMPC. Both of those are really, really extraordinary. And so, also, Times of Refreshing. If you have not seen the TV show, the television broadcast that Pastor Candy and Pastor Steve are involved in, you're giving yourself an in-service, disservice. So tune in, and they are on the Victory Channel. See, y'all say that like, you know, y'all got y'all on TV as well. They're on the Victory Channel, amen? And the Times Refreshing is Saturdays at 10 p.m., that's tonight, amen? Sunday morning at 5:30 a.m. is Times for Refreshing on the Victory Channel. And so you all, this is it for me. I thank God for you all encouraging me, laughing. Where you supposed to. And I thank you all for you, and I'll see you on next year. Amen.
God. Well, listen, one more time. Stand up on your
feet.
Bless
you, Jesus.
We need to do this to activate the room once again. There's a request from the woman of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
To activate the atmosphere. I need you to do me a favor. Put your hand on somebody. Tell them God is mighty. He's mighty.
God
He's
is mighty.
Mighty. But He's mighty in your life. Yes,
Pastor Phil, before we start that song, I want you all to know while I asked him to do it again. You need this is what the Holy Spirit was speaking to me while we were doing that song. He said, tell the ladies, you need to arm yourself with warfare songs. And sometimes when we say warfare, people think sorrowful and heavy. No, your weapon is a praise. But it's not a praise about yourself. It's when you start acknowledging and exalting God. Now this song says, you are a mighty God. The first line in this, the verse says, who is he? What's the next line?
Yeah, who is he? Rules and reigns.
Rules and reigns.
Over everything.
Over everything. Yeah. And all I saw, you know, this is one of my songs. I take this song and I pimp slap the devil with it. Oh, no, I'm serious. I'm not joking. You ever had one of those times where it seemed like everything around you was screaming crazy? And the enemy was, he was trying to press on you and make you think nothing is going to change. This is not going to go right. You're never going to get that. You're never going to make it there. Your body ain't going to ever change. Oh, I got testimonies I can share with you. I remember when from the top of my head all the way to the soles of my feet was totally, totally, totally had sores, had broke out. All I mean everywhere. And when I say everywhere, I mean everywhere. And so, but and the enemy was telling me, you're going to be like this for the rest of your life. And I pull out the song, "You Are a Mighty God." And I take that song and I said, who is he? It ain't you, devil. Not you. That's what I say, not you. Who rules and reigns over what? Everything. So when the enemy is talking crazy and he's talking loud and he's boasting himself so proud, get you some warfare songs and then begin to stomp on the devil's head while you're praising him. Now, I told my husband, you could tell, I didn't party like drinking and all that, smoking and all that stuff, but I did like to dance. Oh, bless his holy name. God didn't take that from me though. See, I don't have to dance in the club. I can dance with the Lord. But I appreciate how he didn't change my dance. Now I can Pentecostal dance with you all night long. I pick them up, put them down, pick them up, put them down. But I can also do a little groove thing. You know what I'm saying? And so what I'm saying, don't get religious on me because I don't even care. I don't care. Because, see, I know what's real. I know what breakthrough in my life. I don't know where your life been, but I got testimonies about breakthrough while I was grooving with the Lord Almighty God. He just tore down some stuff because my praise wasn't in the groove. My praise was in the declaration that he is the Almighty, all creator, all sufficient, unlimited God that I can rest on. He's my anchor. He's my shifter. He's my mighty God. So I want you to take this song and make it your warfare song. Go ahead, Pastor. Hallelujah. We just gonna dance on the devil's head. Listen to everyone.
Come out of them seats right now. Come out of them seats. This is a declaration song. Come on, this is you declaring that God has given you the victory in this house. Come on out, them jets. Come on up front right now. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. We're making our declaration of war, like the woman of God said. And we're standing in the victory. You are he who rules and reigns over everything. Come on up front.
Think about some of those things the enemy's been trying to reign on your head.
You are God, hey, yes, yes. And you mean the world to me, yes. You're number one, God, yes. No one beside thee, yes. You are king. Hey, hey. You rule and reign over everything. You are he who grants dominion and authority. You are alive. Now come on, put your feet up and act like you're walking on the enemy's head. Yes, yes, yes. Saying
you are a mighty God.
Yes, you're ruling in my praise. Victory comes. Can say you are a mighty God because you're ruling and reigning over everything. You are a mighty God. I see you picking your feet up. Come on. And you're worthy of a praise. Come on. Come up and say,
you are God. Hey.
Yes.
You are God.
Yes. And you mean the world to me. You're only number one.
Number one God.
No one beside thee, no devil, no disease, no sickness. Come on, we say it. You
are he.
He rules and reigns.
Rules and reigns over everything.
You are he who.
You are he who.
We exalt your name, God. Grants dominion and authority.
Come on, declare it. You are a mighty God.
Yes, yes. We came to worship and praise your name because
you are a mighty God. Hey, you watch it virtually. Come on and praise him with us.
Hey, come on. Somebody say it. He's a
you are a mighty God.
Yes. And we'll ever bless and praise your holy name. Say
you are a mighty God.
Come on, y'all. And we love to give your name the praise because
you are all that. Not you, devil. God is all that.
Somebody say it.
All that.
Come on, yeah. Warfare with your worship. Somebody say it.
All that.
Come on, raising in the room. Say it.
All that.
Say, oh.
All
yes, he is.
All that.
Unstoppable. Hey. You're powerful. You're the maker.
All that.
Prince of peace, everlasting power.
And the Lord of Lords. He is all that. He is all that. Oh, I love that so much. He's all that. He's the mighty God. He's the mighty God. He's the mighty God. Oh, I can't stop encouraging you, because see, when you leave out of this kunku, this is a kunku. 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 Kaku. Kaku. Kuku. Kuku. This is a covering shelter that you're in right now. So when you come out of this place and you go back into your real world, I want you to have an anchor in your spirit that tells the devil to shut up talking to me, because my God is all that. My God is great and mighty. And there's no limit on him. There's no shortage in him. There's no problems in him. There's no situation that he can't handle. Nothing that God can't take care of. Did I say nothing? Tell your neighbor nothing. Now tell him again. Say you. That includes your situation. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, bless the name of Jesus. I got all kind of notes up here, all kind of stuff. I love the Lord. I like to preach, y'all. I don't know if y'all know that, but I enjoy teaching the word of God. I enjoy worshiping. I just enjoy all the things that God is. Amen? So this is the last session, and I'm here to charge you before you leave out. And I'm going to talk about some things today that God put on my heart. We're going to speak on the path of the righteous. Our theme for this conference has been kingdom business. King's what? Decree. That's why I have this bench up here. Because see, when you're the king or the queen, you just sit down and you say what you want done. You don't see the king running around. You don't see the queen running around hollering and screaming. Mm-mm. even what they say, off with your head, they just do it off with your head. And then the business is carried out. Our theme is kingdom business, king's decree. And the Lord put on my heart to talk about the path of the righteous. That's why I got my comfy shoes on. Because you can be comfortable and whip the devil right upside his head. Oh, yes. So I got some scriptures. So let me start off with Psalms 37, 17 through 19. Psalms 37. Amen. Got some folks in the house that know the word. Psalms 37, 17 through 19. It says this: For the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholdeth the righteous. The Lord knoweth days, excuse me, the Lord knoweth the days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be forever. They shall not be ashamed in the evil time. That's where we are right now. And in the days of famine, they shall be satisfied. Now let me read this to you out of the NIV translation. For the power of the wicked will be broken, but the Lord upholds the righteous. That's us. The blameless spend their days under the Lord's care, and their inheritance will endure forever. In times of disaster, they will not wither. Let me say that again. In times of disaster, they will not wither. In days of famine, they will enjoy plenty. You won't just have a lot and can't enjoy it. No, it says they will enjoy plenty. It's talking about us. I'm going to read it to you. One more translation. This is in the New Living Translation, NLT. For the strength of the wicked will be shattered. I like to just stay there for a minute. The strength of the wicked shall be shattered. You know, our country got some crazy stuff going on that makes no sense. But when you look at it in light of the word of God, and you take the word of God and you use it as your weapon of warfare, you can look at the scripture in Psalms 39, 17 through 19 in the New Living Translation, and it says, for the strength of the wicked will be shattered. You can say, you're coming down, big boy, you're coming down. But the Lord takes care of the godly. You can ask, somebody may ask you, how you making it? How you dealing with everything going on in this land? And you say, the Lord takes care of the godly. Say that with me. The Lord takes care of the godly. Now say, that's me. The Lord takes care of the godly. Day by day, the Lord takes care of the innocent, and they will receive an inheritance that lasts forever. They will not be disgraced in hard times. Another scripture says, those that put their trust in him shall not be made ashamed. Trust in God. Hold fast to him. You will not be made ashamed. But he will. Nisi, I don't know where you are. He will. He told me to tell you, he will. He will take care of everything that's concerning you. He said the Lord will what? He will take care. And he said, but for the strength of the wicked will be shattered. That's how you stand on the word. When you're standing in a situation, you don't just stand on it with mental assent. You take the seed of the word, and you use your mouth as the planting tool in your situation, and you watch, you plant that seed as the word, and it will spring up and do bring you a mighty harvest. So if you're dealing with some situations, take this word, for the strength of the wicked will be shattered, but the Lord takes care of the godly. They will not be disgraced in hard times. Listen to this. Because, you know, you hear these things on the media news. I don't listen to it. But you don't have to listen to the news because enough people are going to tell you what the news said. But it says, listen to this. This is our answer. Even in famine, they will have more than enough. More than enough. Why? Because he's all that. He's a mighty God. You are a mighty God, ruling and reigning over everything. See, I'm talking about, you take that song, that's the word, and you pimp slap the devil. I'm going to teach y'all how to fight in the spirit for real. Something may come against you, but it will turn out the way that you said. Let me say that again. Something may have come against you. Something may be trying to press up on you. Say, don't be pressing up on me. Something may be trying to press up on you, but it will turn out the way that you say it. Thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established. Job 22:28. Thou shalt decree a thing, and what? It shall be established. One of my favorite scriptures. Thou shalt decree a thing. Yeah, I'm going to be up and down, so y'all be ready with the cameras. And it shall be what? Settled. It shall be established. It may come against you, but it will turn out the way you say it will. So you need to tell your situation, tell your need, what God says. What may come in the future that may try to shift you or turn you or worry or trouble you? You open your mouth and you tell that need what God says. Maybe you have a financial situation. You speak to that financial situation and you tell it what who says? Not what the media says. Not what the news says, not what your girlfriend says, unless they speak in the word. But you need to have the word in your heart for yourself. You look at that need and you lay those bills on the table and you start speaking to it, not your feelings, not your emotions, not crying and, oh God, I don't know. No. You speak to that thing and tell it, God said, by his stripes, I'm healed. God said that he supplies all of my needs according to his riches and glory. What did he say in Psalms 37:19? In famine, I'll have more than enough. God says, I have more than enough. More than enough. Not just enough. Not barely making it. Girl, how you doing, child? I'm barely making it. The devil is a liar. That's not what God said. You open your mouth and you decree what God said. God says, I have more than enough. God says, I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above only and never, never beneath. What is God saying? What is God saying about your life? The path of the righteous. I remember when the Lord began speaking this to me. I remember when he spoke that statement to me. It rose up out of my spirit. I was driving in the car. I had just come out of a place, and it just seemed like everything was trying to go wrong, go left, go in the wrong direction. And I hollered out of my spirit, this is not the path of the righteous. I will not tolerate it. And then when it rose out of my spirit, I knew it bypassed my head because my head was trying to talk crazy. But my spirit man rose up and said, declare it again. And I said, this is not the path of the righteous. I will not tolerate it. And I heard the Holy Ghost say, that's right, Candy. Thou shalt decree a thing and it shall be established. I opened my mouth and I decree what God is saying. Kings decree. King's decree. Believing is the attitude of faith. You know, you can have an attitude about yourself. Don't have to be a stank attitude. It can be an attitude of faith. Yes. Believing is the attitude of faith, and speaking is the initial act of faith. Yes. When you are in faith, There's no whining in your voice. I don't know what I'm going to do, Pastor Candy. I just need you to pray for me, girl. The enemy just been doing so much stuff in my life. I just need somebody to pray. I just need somebody to help me, help me, help me. Mm-mm. When you in faith, even when you feeling challenged, there's still no whining in your voice. There is no victim in your voice. The spirit of faith becomes active when we begin to talk back to the problem. The spirit of faith becomes active when we what? Talk back to the problem. I know y'all know how to talk back. Oh, your mama told y'all, don't be talking back to me. So I know you have the ability to talk back. Open your mouth and talk back to that problem. Say, you're not the boss of me. You're not over my life. This is not the path of the righteous. It's not the path. It's not the path of the righteous. Yes. Psalms 37 said, this is the path of the righteous. I'm blessed. I have more than enough. That's your path. This is kingdom business. Decree these things. Kings decree. The spirit of faith has two things. One, I believe and I speak. The spirit of faith has two things. I believe. What do you believe? I believe God. I believe the word of the Lord. I believe his promise. I believe his testimony. I believe that he's faithful. I believe that he's with me and that he's in me. He's not out here and I'm trying to reach him. No, he's in me. The greater one is in me. The greater one is strong in me. You open your mouth and you start decreeing what the word says. I'm strong in the Lord and I'm strong in his power and I'm strong in his might. I'm decreeing a thing right now. Body, you get in line with the word of God. Body, you are strong. You're strong in the Lord. You're strong in the power of his might. Hallelujah. I believe. But you don't just stop at a belief. Because sometimes people say, I believe God. And they do. They really do. They believe God. But you got to open up your mouth and speak. Speak the word. As Jesus told Jairus, speak the word only. Huh. Oh, we can sit right there for a minute. It was good when he said speak the word, but when he put that only in there, you mean I can't tell nobody how I feel? I can't tell nobody what they said about me, how they talked about me, how my husband was acting crazy and my kids on crack and drugs? I can't tell about that. He says speak the word only. Only. You know why he said only? Because you're royalty. And when you open your mouth, good or bad, you're decreeing something. And so when you speak the problem, you're decreeing, you're enlarging, you're giving place to the problem. But when you decree the word of God, you're giving place to the promise. And not only that, guess who's listening? Jesus says, I'm the high priest of your confession. Not only is Jesus listening, but he's given us angels who are standing at alert that hearken to what? The voice of his word. Huh. So you wondering why ain't nothing going on and angels are standing there because I don't do mess. He said, no, we don't do that. We just, when you get around to what God said, that's when we'll activate. But all while you screaming the problem and talking about the situation, you know, God didn't say talk to God about your problem. It said talk to your problem about God. What have you told your situation about God? I know you've been telling God about your situation. And God says, but I made you kings and priests. I've given you authority to rule and reign in this earth, in this time, not in heaven. He said, in this earth, in this time, I've given you authority. I've made you kings. I've made you priests. Rule and reign in this life. He said, what are you saying to your problem? You keep waiting for God to say something to your problem. And God says, it can't happen like that because I've made you the authority on the earth. He said, well, if you speak to your problem, I'll back you up. And I'll activate. It will activate your angels to go forth and do what you need done. Even the devil doesn't care what you believe if you be quiet about it. Even the devil, he don't care what you believe. You can be the best saint Christian. You can know all the New Testament and you got it memorized. I know what the words say. I know what the words say. He don't care. Because you're quiet about it. And if you only do it when you're in church, that's a short-lived victory. Because most of us can't be in church 2 good hours without itching and fiddling. And Lord Jesus, this is the third session of the conference. How many times we going to sing that song, Mighty God? I'm ready. Child, I ain't even hardly getting no lunch. I need a nap. Don't she know I need a nap? No, what you need is a breakthrough. And when you get that breakthrough, you can sleep at night and you don't need all them naps. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Jesus is God. So the devil don't care what you believe. You're not a conqueror because you believe God. You are a conqueror when you believe and speak because it activates your faith. It puts angels at charge. It gives Jesus something to work with. And when you decree a thing, it is what? Established. Hallelujah. Take God's word. Put it in your mouth. Meditate on God's word. Listen to this. So it can renew your mind. Look what it does, Mother. I'm so glad you're here, Mother Mary. Look what it does. You must renew your mind, listen to this, with the truth of the word of God, listen to this, before you even step out in faith. I'm going to say this again. You must renew your mind with what? The word of God. Some people are putting a lot of stuff in their minds, but they don't have no scriptures. They don't know. You ask them, I've done this in prayer. We have in prayer. And I just start walking around the room and I tap people on the shoulder and say, What you praying about? Oh, Pastor, I'm praying about blah, 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 blah. And yet it is here, and yet it is here. I say, oh, that's powerful. That's wonderful. What word, what scripture are you standing on? Well, you know what God said about a situation was, you know what Pastor said the other Sunday. And then, Jesus wept, and then, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. That's good. The Lord is your shepherd, but you got to have revelation knowledge of what that scripture is really waiting of. If the Lord is your shepherd, and you shall not want, what should you be doing there? You should be decreeing, this is not the path of the righteous. The Lord is my shepherd. I don't want for money. I don't want for things. I don't want for peace. I don't want for children acting right. I don't want for a healed and whole body. I don't want for a good marriage. I don't want for promotion. The Lord is my shepherd. When you know the word and you meditate on the word and you take the word and let it renew your mind to what the word is saying, you'll decree some stuff. No, God is my shepherd. Even when you catch yourself acting sideways, we've all been there. But you catch yourself, the word will catch you. I have a statement say, my spirit caught my soul trying to worry. I'm going to say that again. My spirit, you know, the spirit man, you build your spirit man up. But it caught my soul trying to worry. My spirit caught my soul this many months ago trying to worry about this conference. And I opened up my mouth immediately because you got to remind yourself just because a thought comes to you, that's not your thought. Mm-mm. The word of God says, take no thought saying. Why do you say saying? Because when you open your mouth, you take captive. You take ownership of anything that's been rolling around in your head. So you don't say those things. But Pastor Candy, I gotta say it like it is. I gotta tell the truth. Yes, you should tell the truth. But guess what truth is? Thy word is truth. So you got to renew your mind before you even step out on faith. Before you will ever believe or speak, you got to put the word in. Because what the mind believes, the mouth speaks. What the mind believes, the mouth speaks. I'm going to say it again. Whatever your mind is believing, it's going to come out of your mouth. And whatever your mouth speaks, guess what? That shall you have. Think about that. Let's put that in today. Between morning session and this session, what on earth were you saying? Oh, we got quiet in the church house. I get it. We live in a flesh body. But we're not controlled by our flesh if we feed our spirit more than our flesh. Now, if you feed your flesh all day, all night, what I mean, I don't just mean food. I just mean whatever flesh want, that's what you give it. I tell my flesh all the time, you are not the boss of me. You're not the boss of me. I can't tell you how many times I told my flesh that during this conference. You ain't the boss of me. Flesh was like, I'm tired. Shut up. You ain't tired. You're not tired. If I was out shopping, you wouldn't be tired. Mm-mm. I promise it wouldn't be tired. If I was watching HGTV, it would not be tired. Nope, 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 nope. If I was watching Hallmark, it wouldn't be tired. No, it wouldn't be tired. If I was out looking at houses, I like houses. I like property. If I was out driving around in a beautiful area, my flesh wouldn't tell me it was tired. You know what it would say? Oh, let's go over there and look at some more. But because we are disciplining our flesh to do what God has called us to do and adhere to the word of God and renew our minds and sit under the anointing, flesh want to get out of control sometime and say, it's tired. It's too bad. You're going to rest later. Right now, we're going to do what we need so when we need it, we'll have it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it ain't popular, but it's going to help your life. Hey, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. I need to sit there for a minute. It will transform your life. It doesn't matter if it's popular. It doesn't matter whether it feels good or not. It's going to feel real good later. Because when the world gone crazy and your favorite whatever is not in the grocery store and your flesh is screaming, but I want to have it, you've already disciplined that flesh and said, shut up, flesh, you don't need that. It's plenty of food in the vegetable section. Oh, yeah, see, y'all don't want to talk to me now. But, you know, folks be like, oh, the shelves are bare. It sure isn't much in the grocery store. Oh, girl, you know they heard it's been shortages here, shortages coming. I don't say that stuff. Mm-mm. But even in my flesh, try to twitch a little bit because whatever I thought I wanted isn't there. I tell my flesh, let's go to the vegetable section. There's a whole bunch of stuff in there. I saw plenty of cabbage and green beans, string beans and greens all cut. What not? Brussels sprouts. Somebody say Brussels sprouts. Yuck, yuck. You better train your flesh to eat what it needs and not what you want. Oh, you may not like me, but you'll like me when you're 80 and you can still move around real good. Ah, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Ah, yeah. You'll like me real good when you get a doctor's report and they say, you know, you are doing wonderful. Your blood pressure's good. Your sugar level is good. Your heart is working right. What you been doing? Oh, I've been disciplining my flesh, doctor. I've been doing what the word say. You renew your mind. And what the mind believes, the mouth speaks. The door of the supernatural opens by believing and speaking. When you want to open a door for the supernatural in your life, it's operated by believing and speaking, but you must uproot the trees of wrong thinking, fear, unbelief before you speak. Trees of wrong thinking, trees of fear, trees of unbelief. I got rose petals up here. Why did I put this up here? One, I like it. But two, I thought about coming to America. And when the king walked in, what did they do? They threw the rose petals. Because he and she, the king and the queen, they couldn't just walk on regular pavement. They had to have rose petals. They had to adorn the floor to prepare themselves. You better know how to fix yourself up, girl. I'm telling you. Don't be getting it twisted talking about, I don't need all that. No, you need all of that. And some extra. But why? Because you are royalty. That don't mean you get snotty and act crazy. What is that foolishness? What is that foolishness? Come on, can I just side journey for a minute? What is that foolishness? Without God, we crazy. Oh, see, y'all ain't got the realization yet. Let me give you a realization right now, just in case nobody told you lately. Without God, you cuckoo for Cocoa Pops. You couldn't tell your left from your right. You wouldn't even know your name. And you can tell people without God, they showing their whole behind. Both naturally and spiritually. You be like, really? You know they wear their pants all the way down, don't they? They showing their whole behind. You would have thought never would happen. Never would happen. That would never happen. And then you walk and go, oh, my gosh. I was in Walgreens. Somebody say Walgreens. Because we are talking about putting on our royal behavior, right? I was in Walgreens. And I had my head down. I just walked up to the checkout stand, and was a lady standing in front of me. And so I had my head down, so I started to look up from the floor up. But as I was coming up, I said, wait a minute. She got on, like, pantyhose. And she ain't got on nothing underneath. Nothing. Nothing. She had on a short top. I said, Lucy, devil, what in the world? And the Lord, you know what the Lord spoke to me? He said, you'd be just as crazy if you didn't have parents that raised you to do right. Now, I know y'all would think I would never. No, no, no. No, no, no. Without God, we are babbling idiots. But we're not without him. Can somebody lift your hand and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you for capturing me. Thank you for bringing me into your fold. Thank you for loving on me. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace. Come on, y'all not thanking him enough. You must think you all that by yourself. Oh, but without God, we can do nothing. Without God, we can't make it. Without God, we can't put a sentence together. But we're not without him. We're not without him. God is in us. God is with us. And for that, I am eternally thankful. I'm so thankful. Oh, my God, my God, my God. When we were singing that song, Better Than That, because you've been more and more in my life, I just begin to well up on the inside, recognizing, God, you've been good to Candy. Whoo, hallelujah. Anybody can just take a moment and think about how good God's been to you. Oh, he's been good to us. Because of his loving kindness, because of his tender mercies, because of his outstretched hand, we are where we are. We can do what we can do. It's all because of him. Can we just give him all the glory right now? God, we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. It's because of you, God. We take no credit. We take no glory. It's you. It's you. It's you. Whew. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It's because of your blood. It's because of the name of Jesus. I wrote this song. I was in worship one day, and I was just thinking about the goodness of the Lord, and this song began to rise up in my heart. Your goodness overwhelms me. Your goodness overwhelms me. Your goodness overwhelms me, and I say thank you. Oh, I say thank you. And the more I entered into worship, I start saying, your love lifts me up. Yeah. Your love lifts me up. Whew. Your love lifts me up, and I say thank you. Yes. I say thank you. I can't be like the 9 lepers that did not come back to say thank you. Because the one that came back to say thank you, they were made whole. Healing is great, but wholeness is better. I mean, not just you, but your whole family, everything, your finances, your mind got right, your finances got right, your friends got right, your associates get right, your path gets right. I've been made whole. Can you tell somebody I've been made whole? Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. So when we uproot the wrong thinking, we uproot wrong thinking before we speak. Otherwise, we'll continue down the wrong path of defeat and wonder, why isn't this working? Why isn't this working? Truth is, it is working. You are having exactly what you're believing and speaking. See, the scripture says, be not deceived. God's not mocked. Whatsoever man soweth, that will he reap. An Amplified Bible says that and that only shall he reap. Don't be deceived. Don't be looking at God like, God, why haven't you done this for me? God, why haven't you changed this situation? God, why haven't you provided? And God says, don't be deceived. I'm not mocked. Don't be trying to mock me. What you sowed, you reaped. What you're reaping. Whether you sow good or evil. Whether you sow, listen to this, nothing or plenty. I remember years. Oh, it's been a long time. It was back in the 90s. The Lord really started teaching me more and more about how to talk right. And so, very disciplined on not saying wrong stuff and paying attention to what comes out of my mouth. And I came to the Lord just like this, saying, Lord, what's going on? I'm not saying the wrong stuff. It seemed like it's not coming to pass. God said, no, Candy, you're not saying the wrong stuff. But you're not saying the right stuff either. I was like, oh. I was so focused on not talking wrong that I forgot to add talk right. Oh, see, y'all never did that before. It's just me, with me and my husband. But you have to say what you want, not what you see. Call those things that what? Be not. But see, people twist that scripture wrong. They call what they see to think it's going to change to what they don't want. Or they try to call in denial what they see. Girl, I ain't sick. I ain't getting the flu. I ain't got no cancer. You got a bad diagnosis from the doctor. I ain't got no cancer. I'm not receiving that. I don't have arthritis. I'm not receiving that. I don't have high blood pressure. I don't have high sugar diabetes. I'm not receiving that. And they stop right there. What they call in? Nothing. Nothing from nothing leaves nothing. You gotta have something. What? If you wanna be with me, that's what he's saying. So you call in what you want. What do you want? What do you want? I didn't say what's going on. What do you want? Call that thing in. Deny the right for the wrong thing to exist. But open your mouth and decree. King's decree. This is the path of the righteous. This is kingdom business. I decree that I am strong in the Lord. I am strong in his power. I am strong in his might. I have the mind of Christ. I'm not losing my mind. I'm not losing my memory. I'm not losing anything. I have the mind of Christ. I don't believe in senior moments. You better speak that word over yourself. Where in the Bible did you read about a senior moment? Moses said, I'm how old? Y'all better read your Bible. Moses said, I'm 120. And he said, what? I'm more than able to take this mountain. Some of y'all 65 and you saying, girl, I can't hardly make it through the street. Lord, how am I going to make it? And then you tell somebody, well, I'm not as young as I used to be. What that got to do with the price of tea in China? That's not what the word says. Renew your mind. That's trees. See, when I said that, y'all was looking at me like, what is she talking about trees? That's a tree right there. It's a tree of unbelief. What scripture did you find in the word that says the age that you are affects the condition of your body. When you find it, search for it right now if you want to. If you find it, holler it out. I'll wait. That's not what the word says. You don't even have any examples in the word of God. We were listening to Rick Renner, and he was teaching on Genesis. He was teaching on everything that was happening before the flood, the flood with Noah. And he began to talk about the ages of people and how long they lived. And then he said, Noah, boy, I laughed hard because it was funny to me. Noah didn't start having children until he was 500. I was like, what? Baby, you know, we still young. We better start building on a family. We only 500. I just want you to see how far we've come away from what the word says. Trees of unbelief. Trees of fear. Trees of unrighteousness. That is not the path of the righteous. Who are you? I'm the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus. That's what we say. That's who you really are. Tell your sister, you are the righteousness of God in, through, and by Christ Jesus. That's the path of the righteous. This is your inheritance. Why would you forfeit your inheritance? Jesus got beat down so you can have this. Jesus hung on the cross so you could have this. Jesus died and went into the belly of hell. Jesus went to hell. Yes, he did. Yes. For you and for me. If he hadn't, we would have. I don't want to go to hell. Jesus went to hell so we didn't have to experience hell in this life. Why endure hell when you have the path of the righteous and all we have to do, open up your mouth and decree, this is not the path of the righteous. I will not tolerate this in my bloodline. I will not tolerate this in my daughter. I will not tolerate this in my son. I will not tolerate this in my grandchildren. Open up your mouth and decree what the word of God says. I am who God says I am. I can have what God says I can have. And I can do what God says I can do. This is the path of the righteous. King's decree. Thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established. Oh, yeah, y'all catching on now. Pushing forward without aligning your thoughts to be in agreeable with God's thoughts is a dead-end street going nowhere. I'm going to say that again. Pushing forward. Oh, okay, Pastor Ken, I got it. I'm going to do this because... I mean, when you leave out, tomorrow, when I get home, when I get to my room, I'm going to do this. So you in your room, you don't hardly have one scripture. You don't even know where your Bible is, and you don't have an app. If you have one on your phone because somebody put it there, you never took the time to learn how to use it, so you don't really have to use it effectively. I'm talking about people watching via stream. Nobody in this house, surely, but somebody in the nation, somebody in the world, somebody out there, yeah. And so you say you're going to do this thing. And you so you're going to push. Pushing harder. Mm-mm. Maybe if I push harder in the spirit. Because we're going to war in the spirit. We're going to bombard. I had to laugh because it's just funny to me. We're going to bombard heaven. What? Really? What force, what army are you bombarding heaven with? No. Mm-mm. Pushing harder in the flesh will not give you a harvest in the spirit. Mm-mm. No. Pushing forward without changing your mind, renewing your mind, aligning your thoughts to be in agreement with God's thoughts is a dead-end street going nowhere. This is kingdom business. A renewed mind is the apparel of the righteous. This is my royal behavior. This is my royal attire. A renewed mind is part of my apparel. Put on your righteous mind. Put on your righteous behavior. Can we show that scene now from, I like movies. I like clean movies, though. I don't like dirty movies. But so they kind of cornball. I said that because they kind of cornball to some. So this might be a little cornball to you, but it's good anyhow. Can you turn the volume up? This is from Princess Diary.
Hello. What's your name?
Carolina.
And what are your names?
John. Blake.
Did I see you messing with Carolina?
They were tugging on my forehead. Mm.
Excuse me, these children are?
Most of them are orphans. We care for as many as possible.
Kissing children, hugging orphans. What a vulgar, low, despicable political trick.
Carolina, would you like to be a princess today?
I can't, I'm too little, too piccola.
Oh no, because I declare that anyone can be a princess today. Well, why don't we get you a tiara and you can wave and march in the parade. In fact, why don't you all take tiaras?
All? Give them all free tiaras.
I'll take care of it later.
Thank you.
Yo quiero una verde.
¿Quieres una silver one?
Una más de vela.
You won't be able to wave with your thumb in your mouth.
I can only wave with this hand.
Very good.
I want a crown.
Can we be in the parade?
Oh, of course. We could always use more princes in the world. Okay, so to be a princess, you have to believe that you're a princess. You've got to walk the way you think a princess would walk. So think tall, you've got to smile and wave, and just have fun. So are you ready?
Yeah!
She's letting the children join her on trial night.
Not for everyone.
Drum roll, please!
Give the princess a drum roll!
Remember, you are a princess.
I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. And I'll make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away.
There you go. Miss Genovia, Hildegard Hoffman, at the best Independence Day parade Genovia's seen in years, thanks to Princess Mia's special surprise. May the rest of your day be sunny side up.
Amen. But I love when she said, to be a princess, you gotta believe that you are a princess. You gotta walk like you think a princess should walk. I'm going to add to that. You got to talk the way a princess should talk. You behave yourself. I'm going to go even further. You should dress like a princess should dress. That don't mean you have to dress like me, but if half your stuff is showing, baby, that's not the way of a princess. Have you ever seen royalty with their stuff hanging out? Just tell me where. No. I don't mean you got to have it all the way up to here and all the way down to there, but there's some decency. You know how you can easily know what's good and what's bad? Let me tell you how. Ancient Chinese secret. Ask the Holy Spirit. Not when you're in your closet, when you go shopping. Because see, if it's not in your closet, you can't put it on. But when you go shopping, you say, Holy Spirit, would this be pleasing? Is this the garment? Is this the path of the righteous? Am I putting on my royal behavior? Or am I working like the ways of the world? It's simple. I'm not saying dress like one person or the other. Just ask the Holy Ghost. I remember the scripture that says, it would be better that you tie a rope around your neck and throw yourself over a hill than to cause a little one to fall. What do you mean by that? I remember sharing that with my daughters years ago because they were like, well, I don't understand why I can't wear this. I said, well, because you know, when I would talk to them about certain attire, they'd be like, that's the man's problem. That ain't my problem. They need to just control their eyes. And they do. I'm not giving them no loose end. Nope, they do. But that doesn't take us away from our responsibility also. So if I cause that little one, yeah, he carnal, he need God, he need to grow up in God, he need a lot of things. But if I cause that little one to fall, the word of God says I'm not off the hook either. It'd be better that I put a rope around my neck and throw myself over a cliff than to cause a little one to what? Fall. So I think about things like that. There are outfits I will wear when I go out on my go out with my husband, and it's just us. And I don't mean like all out in public. I just mean we just out hanging together in some places that it's just us. I wouldn't wear that if I went out with some couples. Why? I don't want their husband looking at me. He's like, it ain't that you all that. You know what I learned? Let me tell you a little secret. I got a girl talk coming up. I don't know when it's coming up this year, but because the Lord spoke it to my heart. And it's called They Never Told Me That. Yeah, we're going to have some fun with that when I'm telling you. We're going to cover some stuff. It's called They Never Told Me That. And we're going to, it's going to happen this year, probably in December. So you just get ready for it. You get ready to receive email. But this called They Never Told Me That. But you know what the Lord said to me? He said, everybody got it. And he said, the thing is, a man, I'm going to look up in the sky. I'm not trying to come down on men at all. I'm not trying to come down on men. I pray for our men. I uphold our men. We lift them up. Amen. I have an amazing husband, and I'm so thankful for him. Let's give Pastor Steve a shout out anyway. Hallelujah. He supports me in all the craziness that God puts in my heart to do. He walks, he stands with me. He does. I mean, he supports me in prayer. He covers me in prayer. He covers me financially. He gives me vitamins. I'm telling you, that man be on me. He be like, nope, you can't leave yet. Did you eat something this morning? Oh, baby, I didn't eat nothing. Come on, here. I got something ready for you. My husband brings me breakfast to my bed almost every morning. What? I wake up and he in that kitchen cooking something. He said, I made you a salad. I mean, he can make sure it's healthy, too, so I'm not eating wrong because he loves me. Now, we love each other. Don't get it twisted. I'm a good wife. Amen. I don't have no problem saying that. I'm a good wife. But the thing is, if you show it, most men will look at it. Unless he's really conditioned his flesh, he'll look. It don't matter what size you are. So I'm saying that because I'm not saying I won't wear that because I'm so foxy and fine that, you know, every man going to look at me. No, that's not about that. I've learned the carnality of the flesh is if you show it, people will look. I can go a step further. If you show it, women will look. Am I still in the path of the righteous? Yes, I am. And so we have to do these things. If you're going to be a princess, you got to act like a princess, walk like a princess, talk like a princess. Amen? Amen. Now, this session started at 2 o'clock, right? It's been an hour and 30 minutes. Y'all get up off me. Oh, I'm a real king director in the spirit. I understand. I know. If you need to stand up and walk around, y'all, I sat through everybody's session. Oh, yes, I did. And before you ever got here, I was in here decorating the stage. Oh, bless the Lord. And when y'all leaving out of here talking about how amazing this conference is, guess what's going to be happening? We're going to be taking it down. So y'all going to give me some time right now. Thank you, Jesus. Whatever the word of God says about a matter, that's what you renew your mind to. Whatever the word of God says about a matter. Whatever who says, the word of God says about a matter. That's what you renew your mind to. Not your opinion, not the opinions of others, but only what God's thoughts are. That's what you say. This is kingdom authority. Did you know we have the kingdom authority to demolish any wrong thinking and bring every thought to the obedience of God's word? We have kingdom authority. Kingdom authority to demolish wrong thinking and to bring every thought to the obedience of God. In 2 Corinthians 10:5, it reads this out of the Passion Translation. We can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God and break every thought, every arrogant attitude that is raised up in defiance of the true knowledge of God. This is scripture. We capture like prisoners of war every thought and insist that it bow in obedience to the anointed one. Now I want to do this again. My MJ, will you come on up here for me? Hallelujah. I want to show you something. I was studying this and I started having this vision. This is my MJ. It's not my son, but I adopted my son's. This is my friends back there, Delaney's son. Let's give MJ a hand. But I call him my son. This is my prophet right here. It's the prophet. The prophet's in the house, y'all. The prophet is in the house. Oh, thou shalt decree a thing. Don't be looking at me crazy. What do you call your kids? Amen. Am I going to feed back for being down here? I'm good. Okay. So the scripture says, you can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God and break through every, I like that, arrogant attitude that is raised up in defiance of the true knowledge of God. And we capture like prisoners of war every thought to the obedience. We capture every prisoner of war. We say, you ain't going to tell me what I'm going to think. I'm going to think what I want to think. You bow your knee. You get down. You get down. You are not the boss of me. This is your thought. This is your wrong thinking. You tell that wrong thinking, no, I will not think that thought. This is what the word of God says. I am not losing my mind. I got the mind of Christ. I'm not losing my family to 1,000 generations. God said the promise goes to 1,000 generations. My house is saved. My kids are saved. My grandchildren are saved. My nieces and nephews are saved. My sisters and brothers are saved. No, thought. I take you into prison. I'm not going to break your chain. But it becomes your prisoner. And you command it to bow down to the word of God. And you subdue it to the promises of God. Wake your neighbor if they fall asleep. You ain't got time to fall asleep. You got too much going on in your house to be falling asleep. Yeah, I said it. I did say that, didn't I? I did. But it's so true. Because right, stay right there. Right in the midst of craziness, you can't sleep. When the word of God go forth, that's going to get you out of that craziness. The enemy will say, oh, you so sleepy. You so tired. Oh, I am, child. Well, how come you wasn't tired when you had all that craziness going on in your life? You was the same. It was the same flesh. Did you get a new flesh when the word was going forth? You was in the same body, right? The same body. Same body. Somebody say same body. Same body. But all of a sudden when the word going forth, you're, I'm so tired, Jesus. You reading your Bible and you start falling asleep. You watching your show and you wide-eyed. You be like, girl, watching the game, watching the football or something. Some ladies like sports. I'm not one of them. But some ladies like sports. Watching fashion shows. Watching reality TV, which I think is pure trash. I feel like this. Why would I watch your life when I can watch my own and gear it into the right direction? But you take that thought and you bring it into a prison. Excuse me. Hallelujah. You bring it into a prison of war and you insist. It's not a suggestion. You insist that it bows its knee to the anointed one. It bows its knee. It bows in obedience. You're like, well, I can't help what I think. Where did you read that at? Where's that scripture at? See, I'm going to ask you, anytime you say something crazy, something negative, I'm going to say, okay, oh, where's that scripture at? Because this is the path of the righteous. In order to really get to where God has called you to be, in order to do everything God has called you to do, you're going to have to get on the right road. I can't take any road to this resort, Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. I cannot take 55 south to Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. I certainly can't get on 57 and get here. Why? Am I going in the right direction? Will I ever get there? maybe if I drive faster, I'll get there. What if I buy a better car, a new car? I'm driving in the best car, the highest paid car, and I put all premium gas in my car. Will I get to this destination? Then what makes us think when we go contrary to what the word of God says, if we do it faster, if we do it better, if we reach a higher place in the world, we think we're going to get the thing we're desiring of? God said you're on the wrong road. This is not the path of the righteous. Kings decree what the word of God says, and it shall be established. It will transform your mind. It'll transform your body. It'll transform your family. Don't get it twisted. Don't let thoughts, I ain't finished with you, get back on your knee. You ain't going nowhere. So that's what you got to do with them thoughts. Am I the only person that the enemy try to say stuff to you? See, you, because right when you think, girl, don't leave me, don't get it twisted. And now y'all know I'm telling the truth right now, and y'all going to know. Anytime you just got through fasting and praying, you came out of conference, you think you're going to do, oh, I'm doing good. I'm going to do real good now, Lady Deborah. I'm going to do real good. As soon as you get out there, you say, girl, my feet killing me. Lord Jesus. And you be like, what just happened here? You got to bring that thought and don't say it. You may feel it, but you keep it under with the word of God. What does the word of God say? What is God saying about your situation? What is God saying about your life? What is God saying about the promises that he's given unto you? The Lord is our King. The Lord is our Savior. The Lord is our Master. Jesus is our high priest of our confession. He's directing us. The Holy Spirit is our teacher. He's our comforter. He's our guide. How often do you talk to him? How often do you ask him, what should I do in this situation? Now I got one more point. I'm going to skip ahead. You can get a thought. Now you MJ. MJ, you can get up. Thank you. Let's give MJ a hand. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm trying to skip ahead because it's so much. I know I'm going to finish this in Maranatha. Not tomorrow. Bless the Lord. Not tomorrow. Hallelujah. Well, I could. My husband probably would say hallelujah. But you got to prove what God said you are believing. Make sure you have chapter and verse. Prove that he said what he said. Prove that it is a New Testament promise. I'm going to conclude with this, even though I'm not finished. I'll finish, I don't know, maybe tomorrow. I don't know. But I'll finish. So those that are watching via stream, until next time. Make sure what you are saying is a New Testament promise. Why New Testament, Pastor Candy? Because there's the Old Testament, there's the New Testament. Not that we do away with all of the Old Testament, but we learn the lesson from the Old Testament, but we come up higher. You say, well, look, it's like this. Horses are good, right? At one point, that was the mode of transportation, riding a horse. And you would really hate to try to ride your horse from Chicago to, let's say, Memphis, Tennessee. Even though it's an 8-hour drive, I have no idea. Let's even go further than back than that. It wasn't even horses, donkeys. Like, I don't know how Mary did it. I don't know. She had a, oh, my God. There was a grace on Mary. Why you say Mary? Because she was pregnant and she had a child. And she rode on a donkey. It wasn't even a paved road. It was rocks and everything. I didn't even want to ride in a car when I was pregnant, let alone on a donkey. You know that donkey stank? I couldn't always take no smells. Now I'm got to do the smell of a donkey, Lord Jesus. And she rode on that. But why would we do a ride a horse when we can drive a car? Doesn't mean horses aren't good. But God has elevated us. And so the Old Testament is not bad, but he sent Jesus. Woo-wee. He sent Jesus. And Jesus said, I've come to fulfill the Old Testament. And so make sure what you're saying is proven in a New Testament promise. Not something that Jesus already won the victory over, but something that you are stuck in an old covenant mindset. I say that again. Prove that it is a New Testament promise. And not something that Jesus already won the victory over. But you're stuck in an old covenant mindset. Let me give you an example. Love thy neighbor as thyself. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. That's part of the Ten Commandments, right? Isn't that wonderful? That's so wonderful. And as awesome as this is, but what if I don't love myself? That's really what the problem is in a lot of people. Because they're trying to love you like they love themselves. They don't even love themselves. They don't even know how to love. And so, even though the Word of God says in the Old Testament, love thy neighbor as thyself, when you measure your actions for your neighbor based on you, you've already started off short. But when you do what Jesus said, he said, a new covenant I give to you. In John 13:34, can you put that up? A new commandment I give unto you. I want to make sure we see this. John 13:34 in the King James Version. John 13:34 in the King James Version. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm laughing at something. I'm not even going to tell you what I'm laughing at because it's going to get you distracted. But that's some funny stuff. Hallelujah. John 13. Can we get it? John 13:34? It's coming up. Okay, awesome. He says, a new commandment I give unto you. Now, the old commandment was love thy neighbor as thyself. But do you know how many people don't love themselves? Or even if you love yourself to a measure, what if I love myself better than that? So now you're going to measure how I do for me the way you do for you. And that's what's wrong with people. I wouldn't live in a house like that. But see, you're not me. I wouldn't drive a car like that. I'm so happy for you. That's why you're not me. I wouldn't have a spouse like that. Okay, but you're not me. So, because see, they're based on their love for themselves on how you should be conducting your life. But my life is not conducted by your life. And so even though love thy neighbor as thyself is good, but it's an Old Testament scripture, God has brought us to a higher place in John 13:34. Can we read it together, please? Let's read. A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Pause. How has he loved us? Unlimited love. Unlimited love. See, your love has a shortage. You only going to do me wrong so many times before I just say, okay, I'm done with you. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying this is what people say. But that is not the way God loves us. He says, I have given you a new, somebody say new, new commandment. Somebody say it again, new commandment. I give unto you that you love one another as I love you. God loves us unconditionally. God loves us with no limitations. God says, if you ask of me, I'll do it. And then he says, that ye also love one another. And so if you have an Old Testament promise, but you're trying to get a New Testament victory, it's not going to work. I'm going to have to come to a close because I feel it. So I'm not going to press y'all past that. So you're going to have to tune in. Maybe I will. Pastor, can I preach this tomorrow? I know he was going to say, yeah, I know my husband. He'd be like, girl, what? I hear Jesus. I hear Jesus speaking. But you can't get New Testament life with Old Testament promise. You got to come to what Jesus said, and then you're going to walk in the way of Jesus. This is the path of the righteous. Kings what? Decree. Thou shall what? Decree a thing, and what's going to happen? It shall be established. You say, well, Pastor Kennedy, that's an Old Testament scripture. Yeah, but I can take you to Mark 11. Put up Mark 11, 22, 23, 24. Y'all work with me. I know y'all like, Pastor Ken, you need to give me these scriptures. This is my last scripture. You say, that's how you know I'm a minister. I said, this is my last closing. This is my third time. So I'm authentic. Just like you told God you was going to pray and he's still waiting. Oh, did I say that? Ooh, loose here, devil. Loose here. Mark 11, 22, 23. It says, have faith in God. Let's see it together. Let's read it together. And Jesus answering said unto them, what? Have faith. Before we keep going, you know why Jesus, what was the reply? He said, answering said unto them. What happened right before this? Somebody tell me. It's Sunday school class. I don't go to Sunday school, but y'all tell me. What happened? What happened to the fig tree? What'd they see? Jesus, there we go. See, somebody read their Bible. Look at God. We got Bible readers in the house. Yeah, remember Jesus saw a fig tree from far off. He was hungry, so he went to go get some because it wasn't the season for fruit, but it looked like it was going to have fruit. So when he got up there, he was like, well, if you look like you're righteous, I think you're righteous. So I'm going to call you to do some righteous stuff. And then we start coming to pick some fruit. He'd be like, you faking and providing what? You ain't got no fruit. Okay, y'all ain't ready for that. That's tomorrow. You ain't got no fruit. He came to get fruit. He from afar off, you look sanctified. You look like you was the righteousness of God within Christ Jesus. So he said, well, let me call you out and let's do some things. Let's do some things for the Lord. Let's do some things for the Lord. And then he coming to you and say, oh, God, wait now. And he's like, what? You look like you have fruit. But when he came a little bit closer, he said, ain't no fruit. So he said, that's okay, sweetheart. You're going to be all right. No, he did not. He cursed that fig tree. And he said, no fruit shall bear thee hereafter forever. He didn't say for this season. He said, no, he uprooted that bad boy. And he didn't do it with a pick and an axe. He spoke to it because kings decree. He said, I ain't got to get ugly. All I got to do is open up my mouth and decree a thing. He looked at that tree. He said, yep, you're done. And so then they left. And then on the way back, 24 hours later, why did I say 24 hours? Because the word of God says on the next day, on the morrow, Peter, seeing the fig tree, said, Master, look a here. The fig tree that you cursed has withered away. And I love how the scripture say, the sister brought it out, it dried up from the root. Why does that bless me? Because you can't see when the root is drying up. So you might have spoken something that God told you to speak. And on the surface, you don't see no change. Don't you change, baby. You hold your position of faith. You stand on that anchor of the word of God and declare it has dried up from the root. And if you stand fast in the promise of God, you will see that thing destroyed, cursed, gone, withered away, plucked up out of your life. The word shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish and prosper whereunto I send it. I am a king and I decree in the name of Jesus, I have the victory. So he said what? Jesus said, answering, said unto him, have faith in God. So what? Keep going. There you go. For verily I say unto you, and this is my last one. I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain. Let's read that one more time together. Say that what? So that whosoever shall say unto this mountain. You got to speak to your mountain. Don't tell to God about your mountain. Tell your mountain about your God. Stop telling God what the doctor said. Stop telling God what the news media said. Stop telling God what your bank account said. Stop telling God what your body said. Stop telling God what your children are doing. Speak to it. See, I got scripture for this. Whosoever shall say unto this what? Mountain. So you talking to mountains now? You got that right. I'm talking to the mountain. Your body get attacked with flu. Don't talk to God about the flu. Talk to the flu about your God. COVID can't have you. You talk to COVID about your God. Sugar diabetes can't have you. You talk to sugar diabetes about your God. Cancer can't have you. You talk to cancer about your God. Arthritis can't have you. You talk to arthritis about your God. Thou shalt say unto this mountain, do what? Be thou removed. So what are you doing right now? You're calling those things that be not. Because see, you are seeing, you obviously see the mountain because you're talking to it. So the mountain is not removed. But you don't say, you don't look at the mountain and say, Lord, I need this mountain move. This mountain gonna move. This mountain, oh, this is a big old mountain. What I'm gonna do with about this mountain, Lord, this mountain, the devil done put a mountain in my way, Lord, what I'm gonna do about the mountain? And Lord said, I ain't gonna do nothing about it because you ain't doing nothing about it. And when you start saying what I tell you to say, that's what I'm gonna say. It said, you open your mouth. Everybody stand up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You open your mouth. It's time to open our mouths. You open your mouth. You open. Who's open? I can't open my mouth for your mountain. Your mountain needs to hear your voice. Your mountain, your situation needs to hear your voice. What is that thing that's been trying to conquer in your life? What is that situation that's been trying to move in and act like it has all power, all authority? No, you speak to your mountain and command your mountain. Let's look at the thing right now. Before we do this, we're about to do this right now. What is it? What is it, Steve? What is it that before you came here was pressing on you? What is it for the last 6 months that's been trying to tell you I'm not going nowhere? What is it? Go ahead and play, private. What is that mountain? I want you to get an image of that thing because we're getting ready to speak to it. I'm going to speak to anything that tried to come up in my life, and you're going to speak to yours. And if you're watching via stream, I want you to take time, stand up right where you are, or you can sit down if you want to, but we're standing up in here because we're going to decree some stuff. The word of God says in Mark 11:23, speak to your mountain. Thou shalt decree a thing. Yeah, please speak. Hallelujah. You're going to speak to that thing. You're not going to have a thought about it. You're not going to have an ooey-gooey feeling about it. You're not going to get in an emotional fit about it. You're going to open your mouth and you're going to say, you have no authority in this house. You have no authority in my life. And you're going to speak to it and command it. This is not a suggestion. I command you to be removed. Hallelujah. You got it? You got it? You know what it is? Okay, now let's keep playing, baby. And let's read this together. Here we go. That whosoever, let's read together. That whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Now I want you to right now begin to speak to your mountain. Come on, begin to talk to that thing. Command it in the name of Jesus. This is not the path of the righteous. You have no authority in my house. You have no authority in my body. You have no authority in my church. You have no authority in our city. I speak to you right now in the name of Jesus. Confusion, lack, anything that's trying to come against your home, you speak to it right now. In the name, in the name, in the name. Yes. Tell that mountain about your God. Begin to tell him who your God is. Oh, my God is great. My God is mighty. He's better than that. He's all that. He's more. He's more. He's more. He's good to me. Hallelujah. The Lord is my shepherd. I do not want. I don't want for peace. I don't want for sleep at night. I don't want for a healed body. I don't want for my sugar levels to be normalized. I don't want for my joints to act right. I don't want for my blood cells to be regulated. Oh, the Lord is my shepherd. And I don't want for my kids to live righteous. I don't want for my husband to live righteous. Oh, my home is full of peace. My marriage is full of peace. My blessing, the blessing of the Lord is on me. The blessing of the Lord is on my children. The blessing of the Lord is on my house. The blessing of the Lord is on my finances. I'm blessed when I go in. I'm blessed when I come out. Oh, I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above only and not belief. I'm the lender and not the borrower. God has made me rich because Jesus died. He's God. He became poor that I might become rich. Hey, 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 hey. That's who I am. Stay right there. I hear something. That's who I am. That's who I am. I'm the righteous of God in Christ Jesus. That's who I am. That's who I am. I was born into the kingdom. I was born into the family of God. I was born into the bloodline of Jesus Christ. I'm a new creation. I'm a new creation. Old things have passed away. All things have become new. Who I am. That's who I am. That's who I am. I'm living in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. I'm seated at the right hand of the Father in Christ Jesus. That's who I am. I'm born again. I'm changed. I'm renewed. That's who I am. I am that He says that I am. That's who I am. Say right there. That's who I am. I am born in the kingdom of God. That's who I am. Yeah. Yeah. That's who I am. Yeah. That's who I am. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm the righteousness of Christ in this life. That's who I am. Y'all sing that. Say, that's who I am. That's who I am. Yeah, say it again. That's who I am. Yes, I'm loved by the Father. I am loved by the Father. That's who I am. Yeah, yeah. That's who I am. Yeah, I want you to leave with this thought today. That's who I am. Yes, yes, yeah, yeah. I have peace. I have peace and the mind of Christ. That's who I am. That's who I am. That's who I am. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. That's who I am. I am washed in the blood of Jesus. I am washed in the blood of Jesus. That's who I am. Oh, that's who I am. That's who I am. That's who I am. That's who I am. I'm going back with Jesus. I am going back with Jesus. That's who I am. Grab your sister by the hand. That's who I am. Yeah, all across. Just stretch across. That's who I am. Everything He's made me to be, that's who I am.
That's who I am.
I am changed by His image, changed in His likeness. That's who I am. Hallelujah. That's who I am. Hallelujah. Yeah. I am born in the Christ. That's who I am. Hallelujah. That's who. That's who I am. While you're holding that hand, I want you to begin to pray over that sister. As we leave this place, Father, you've been amazing. You've been amazing. You've been amazing, God. You've been amazing, God. Just begin to thank Him. God, everything I needed, everything I was asking for coming to this conference, Father, you exceeded it abundantly above. I needed to dance. I needed to laugh. I needed to shout. I needed to pray. I needed to find out who I am. I needed a mind renewal. Hallelujah. Father, you're so amazing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's who I am. I'm a child of the King. That's who I am. I'm born again. That's who I am. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. That's who I am. Hey! Woo! Hallelujah. I'm changed. That's who I am. I'm changed into His image, changed into His likeness. That's who I am. That's who I am. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Sin has no hold on me. Sickness has no hold on me. Confusion has no hold on me. That's who I am. That's who I am. I am covered by the blood. That's who I am. Here we go. Listen to this. I am wealthy. I am healed. I am saved. I am chosen. I am spirit-filled. I am born again. That's who I am. Yeah, 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 yeah. I am saved. I am covered by the blood of Jesus. I have angels all around me. That's who I am. That's who I am, yeah. That's who I am, yeah. That's who I am, yeah. I am born of the Lamb of God. That's who I am. So God, again, I thank you. Again, I thank you. You're so faithful. You're so faithful. Just love on your daddy for a minute. You're so good, Lord. You're so good to us. You've been so good to us, God. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your goodness. It overwhelms me how good you are. Ah, how loving, how forgiving, how merciful you are. Thank you. You provide every time, every time, every time, every time. You provide all the time. Thank you, God. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that covers us. The angels of God that are encamped around about us. Thank you, Father, as we leave this place, we never leave your presence. But we're covered. We're chosen. We're redeemed. That's who I am. Woo. That's who I am. Yeah, 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 yeah. That's who I am. I'm redeemed by the blood. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. Yeah, sing that again. That's who I am. That's who I am. Yeah, yeah, that's who I am. That's who I am. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. That's who. That's who I am. Hallelujah. Yeah. Ladies, I love you so much. I want you to know you're loved by the Father. You're loved by the Father. The love of the Father is upon you. Pastor Steve and I, we love you with an everlasting love. We pray for you. I knew every person's name that was registered for this conference, even those that are watching virtually. How do I know your name? Because I've been calling your name out one by one. Yep, you see, all of them, Pastor Ken, all of you all, every name. That's why I wanted people to register, because I can call your name out. And when this conference is over, I'm going to keep calling your name out. See, I got your name now. And then I can pray in the Holy Ghost, and whatever the Holy Spirit wants to speak over you, it can just go even further and pray out the mysteries of his will. Go ahead and take your seats for a moment. I want to give you one last opportunity to give. You say, Pastor Candy, I gave. And I thank you. I thank you for giving. Those that are watching via stream, all the ways are on your screen. If you have something you want to give, there's a thanksgiving offering to the Lord for what he's done. Go ahead and pass out envelopes if you'd like to have an envelope. Receive an envelope. That's who I am. I'm going to record this, y'all. That's who I am. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's who I am. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. See, when you got that in you, that's the path of the righteous. That's the path of the righteous. When you know who you are in Christ Jesus, you don't go to the left or to the right because you say, no, that's not who I am. When I would leave the house, all of my sisters can attest to this. Before we would leave the house, my mother would always say, remember who you are and remember who you represent. Every time. If you left out before she could get it, she'd come to the door and holler. You could be halfway down the block, Candy, I kid you not, and you have to come back, and she'll say, remember who you are, and remember who you represent. And that's what word I'm going to leave with you all as we're leaving this place. Remember who you are, remember who you represent. This is kingdom business. Put on your royal behavior. Let's receive the offering. Father, I thank you for those that are giving, whether via stream and giving Cash App, GiveLify, Zelle, PayPal, or giving through the mail. Father God, I think checks are written out to Stephen and Una LaFleur Ministry. I thank you for every seed that's been sown. Father, I decree a 100-fold return into their hearts. into their lives. I thank you for that. I need you to lift your hand if you received it. I decree new contracts, new open doors, favor. Favor, that's the word the Lord keeps giving me for Pastor Phil and Lady Vondria. Favor like you've never experienced before. Favor, favor, favor. Favor over your life like you've never experienced before. I decree it in the name of Jesus. Doors are open unto you. Ways have been made. Things that were sold you could not have, and places you were told you could not do, and promotions that you were told you could never get. God says right now, I've shifted things, and right now I've changed things, and I decree in the name of Jesus, it's coming into your life, it's coming into your hands, it's coming to your children, it's coming to your children's children. The lack that the enemy is trying to haunt you with shall not exist in your house, shall not exist in your pocket, shall not exist in your bank account. There should be no lack, there should be no famine, because you know who you are. In the name of Jesus, I decree it. That's who I am. Go ahead and receive the offering. Thank you, Lord. That's who I am. I'm redeemed. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. Hallelujah. That's who I am. Yes, it is. That's who I am. That's who I am. That gives way new meaning to you don't know about me. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. Come on and testify to somebody. Tell them, that's who I am. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's who I am. That's who I am. I'm healed and I'm made whole. I am healed and I'm made whole. That's who I am. Hallelujah. That's who I am. God bless you, ladies. I love you. Hug somebody and love on them as we are dismissed. Product tables are still open if you want something. Don't forget about the selfies. Take your selfies. I haven't seen, Holly, any posts on social media. Come on, tag me in your social media. Put in the chat. Put in your pictures. Hashtag GPW23. Again, hashtag GPW23. And tag Pastor Candy. Candy LaFleur, just look for me on social media. Stephen and Candy on Instagram. Go ahead and tag us. I want to hear what the conference has done for you. Are we having after the session conference? Okay. All right. And so I want to hear what this has done for you. Y'all always want to talk me into doing it again. Well, I didn't want to hear what this happened this time. So I want to hear about it. You don't have to tell me right now, but you can send me an email. You can send me a text message. Just encourage us. Let us know. Amen. I can see it on your face. It's changed. Oh, you're lighter. That's who I am. God bless you and good night. That's who I am. I am redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am. Hallelujah. We're going straight into after the session. With Stephen Lynn Davis. God bless you.
I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. That's who I am.
That's who I am.
All right, that's we are blessed and highly favored. Did you enjoy that service on today?
Oh, my God.
Amen.
On today. All day.
Oh, not just today.
Yes. Yesterday, too. Yes. It was powerful. It was wonderful. God's phenomenal woman. I had to take down every word. I had to write the word down so I could go back and look at it and it could come back to my remembrance. And as I was looking at it, I had to buy this book. And it says, God's phenomenal wonder, kingdom business. It's God's perfect word.
You want that book here?
God's perfect word is what I kept seeing.
Amen.
God's perfect
Amen.
Word. Everything that was ministered, everything was said. I don't care where you stand as a woman of God. It's for me.
Amen.
It was for me.
Did you buy that book here?
Yes.
You all can still get this book online or through Candy LaFleur or God's Phenomenal Women, any of the ministry. You can buy this as well and put your own words down in there so you can go back and read it again.
Meditate on it.
May I have
Let it
your
come
na-
back up.
Yes, ma'am. May I have your name?
My name is Vondria Tarver.
Vondria?
Vondria Tarver, like Andrea, but Vondria.
Andrea Tarver.
Yes.
And Miss Tarver, where are you from?
I am from South Holland, Illinois. Me and my husband, Pastor Phil Tarver, Pastor Ann Harvey.
Phil Tarver?
Yes.
The young man that did all the singing here?
Yes, that young man.
That's your husband?
That's my cover. Yes.
Wow, your house is blessed with worship and praise all the time.
We are blessed because we continue to speak the word of God as the woman of God said.
Amen.
And to pray and to bring it back to what God has spoken over our lives. This conference was such, I can say it was so timely for where I am now. And I'm sure some of the other women can say the same thing. It was so timely and so needed. Every word, keeping, you know, how we, our apparel as far as being quiet,
yes,
and
yes,
meek and humble. And then the woman of God came this afternoon speaking about, you know, when we come before the King and make our presentation. And she's such an intercessor. She just reminded me, even as an intercessor, you got to be so careful. When you come, you got to expect an immediate response. Immediate
Amen.
Response. And Amen. Even as the visionary of this conference,
yes,
Candy LaFleur, I thank and praise God for Pastor Candy LaFleur. I thank and praise God for the vision, yes, that she has concerning it. And even as she reminded us, I mean, not just reminded us, but she even gave new insight.
New insight.
If you're not
new
speaking,
revelation.
You're not doing nothing.
Wow.
You got to speak the word
you
of God.
Speak it.
You can't
Amen.
Just say, okay, I'm not going to speak the negative thing, but I got to make sure I'm speaking the positive
Amen.
Thing, and I got to make sure I'm speaking by faith.
Yes, and she said to decree it.
Decree it
and
declare
happen.
It, and it shall be established.
Oh, my. When you got a word in your belly,
yes,
the Bible says out of your belly, will flow.
Rivers.
It will flow rivers. It will flow love. It will flow joy.
Living water.
She said, the King said, decree a thing.
Yes.
God said, decree it. We're going to put on our royal behavior.
I'm a king. I'm a king.
She is a king. King, queen.
Yes.
We some of everything,
yes,
wrapped up in God.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. Sister Tarver, Pastor Phil Tarver's wife.
Thank you.
Pastor Tarver's wife.
Bless you.
Amen.
Bless you.
Amen. First lady.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless
God
you.
Bless you.
We're going to stand right here. And we're going to talk to this young lady. So we have all kinds of women that was here in this service. Young, old, rich. Some is not as wealthy as the others. But we all have to put on our garments of righteousness.
Yeah.
We have to look a certain way. No matter what you have in your pocket, you got to stand up tall. You know, nowadays they say we all are queens. Everybody's saying they're a queen. But we are really royal queens of God.
Yes.
And we have a young queen here. Young queen, what's your name?
Andrea McAdams. Andrea.
Andrea.
Yes.
Amen. When I came in today, standing at the door, Miss Andrea, like all of the other women, she came in dancing. She came in just doing her thing. She was really doing it. I said, you know what? I think we need Andrea to let the young women know that we need you all. We need you all here. We need you all there. There is something for all of us to do. Sister Andrea, what did you receive in this service?
Just just so much, though, that it's important, I feel like, for my generation to take the time to work on, because we talk a lot about self-care, but
Amen.
Spiritual care, because like, or even, because you'll say, oh, self-care, shopping, I'm a shop, that was my thing, but God's like, no, I need you to get away with me in the busyness,
yeah.
And then also with social media, it's all about the look. People have great pictures, great trips, great things, your great car, your great family, but God wants to deal with, that's what he was saying to me, like, I want to get underneath. So I feel like my generation needs to not just look good, but actually get before the King of Kings and allow him to give you that thing that we're all looking for, which is, that can't be filled by material things, it can't be filled by an experience, it can't be filled by a perfect relationship. So it's important to pursue that.
Amen.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
That was wonderful. We're going to put on our royal attire. And when we step out now, we're going to step out with our heads up and our shoulders back. And we're going to decree some things.
Yes.
We're going to let the devil
Amen.
Know he ain't running nothing.
Nothing.
The pastor, Candy LaFleur, said we're going to pimp slap the devil upside his head. So after we get through stepping them,
stepping on them, we're going to pimp slap them upside his head. We are, amen. We are so wonderful that you joined us on today and you joined us all week. And we pray that you have received the blessing, everything that you need. I pray that God give it to you and he give it to you double. As you go out there and decree a thing and settle it, let it be settled in your spirit and let God use you the more. Thank you for attending God's Phenomenal Women, and we hope to see you real soon. Stay tuned. There's always something else coming up. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. You all be safe. Pray for our safe travel as we go. Bless you all. Thank you. Thank you all.